You guys, the first Street Choke Mastery Seminar.
Deal.
Thank you guys. You guys, we're so excited to be here, but we can say confidently, especially based on our discussion yesterday and all the details we're going to share with them today, this might be the most important seminar you ever do in your life. It certainly falls in the realm of the most important ones we've ever taught because of the nature of the seminar. In Jiu-Jitsu, the question is there, gi or no gi? That's the question. And what do the gi people say? Yeah, gi for life. Gi is more street because you're going, people wear clothes in the street fight, especially where it's cold. What do the no gi people say? They go, no, training with a gi all 80% of the time makes no sense because people don't walk around in gis. And unless you live in Chicago and everyone's wearing jackets all the time, it's not realistic to train in the gi because that's not going to be available to you in a real fight.
People didn't grow up in our family though, so they did not grow up hearing my grandfather, Elio Gracie, always tell us that the reason why we wear gis is because people wear clothes.
Right.
So gis are to substitute for our clothes in the street.
I think so.
And we're going to explore that today.
And here's what we have to say about this, you guys. We strongly believe and always have been taught that gi is more street than no gi, both offensively in terms of grabbing an opportunity and in terms of your defensive capability. Because if you're used to never getting grabbed in your life, and the minute you get into a fight, someone starts doing this on you, everything gets clogged up when they grab you. And if you're training gi, you're used to that grab. Gi is more street than no gi, we believe. But here's what you're gonna learn today. And if you don't believe this by the end of the seminar, you get your money back. T-shirt is more gi than gi. So what's gonna happen is this. You're gonna leave the seminar today 100% convinced that in a street fight, you would rather the person be wearing a T-shirt than a gi. You guys say, no way. And here's what's crazy. You're looking at us like we're crazy. But that's why we're so happy you're here today, because you're gonna leave the seminar and you're gonna say, oh my gosh, it's so true. And when you walk around, you don't walk around like you guys do today, especially the blue belts walk around like, oh, that guy's wearing a jacket, I could cross choke him, or I could do this. Oh, look at that guy. I got my sleeves on today so I could Ezekiel choke that person. Okay, so you're not walking around like that anymore. You're gonna walk around every T-shirt you see. Free chokes, free necks. Everywhere, more than are available in the gi. Is that unbelievable, yes or no? It's unbelievable, and this is why we're so excited. Because here's what it boils down to. Let's talk about the nature of what's going on here and what we're gonna cover today, right? When it comes to the gi, this is just a little introduction to the concepts we're gonna see today. When it comes to the gi, why is the gi such an asset against someone, right? Let's say Hidong has this on here, right? Why is it an asset for me against Hidong that he's wearing the, what about the gi makes it an asset for me? Ropes. There's a rope around his neck that's just sitting there. Take away all the fabric for a second and just look at the lapel. It's a rope. And the fact that at any point I can go like this, one, two, and grab the rope and then pull, and there's tension on the back of the rope because it's firm and it's strong, makes it an asset for me against him.
Any point.
Oh, your defense is solid. I respect that. Okay, so when he don't walks around in his gi, he's less chokeable than the average Joe. I get it, okay? There's another rope. Do you guys see the other rope in the gi? The other rope. If this is one rope, there's one other rope in the gi. Where? Well, interestingly, like you could call this a rope. The skirt around the lower hem of the gi right here, that's also a rope. If you were to take that, right, and one strip of that fabric, that's a rope that could be used to strangle someone, and there are chokes in jiu-jitsu that do that. There's another one, right? And it's this one. Hug my neck, grab your own inner sleeve. Look, there's the rope around his wrist. Such that, you see it? Go for it, show them what they're, so those who don't know. Look, it's over. That's called an Ezekiel choke. And that's a rope when you can grab inside. Anybody who's trained any extent of jiu-jitsu knows that and loves that rope as much as they love the rope around their opponent's neck. So what we realize is, wow, if jiu-jitsu and the gi, asset value of the gi is all, it's not because of this grip, you know what I'm saying, that is valuable. That's not what makes the gi valuable training. What makes it valuable is that his neck is exposed and I have that rope for or against. So if that's true, the question is, how many ropes can we find in the fight? Hidon, you can take that off, please. How many ropes can we create in the fight, right? So essentially, this is the gi when we talk about the lapel, right? Not including the Ezekiel. But look, if this person has this rope, let's say we were grappling and we're rolling around and this was near heat on in any fashion, there's my rope right there. Boom, that's all I need, it's the rope. Now, the only thing more valuable than an open rope, this is an open rope, it's not connected, it's not closed. The only thing more valuable than an open rope is a closed rope. Look, it's this rope. Because when it's closed, it has tension without you doing anything. It creates, it's almost like there's a third hand holding it together, and then you have your two arms to manipulate it, such that if this goes on his arm right here, right, and we're able to find this rope in a fight, and it's closed, there's the choke. Or if I'm on his back and I'm holding this here, we have other options, boom, from the back that were never possible. So the work today, I know, we're starting to earn you over now. Listen.
No, they're worried about me.
Oh, your health.
Yeah.
Listen, you guys, the point is this. What we're gonna teach you today, we call it Street Choke Mastery Seminar. No, this is Rope Mastery Seminar. And what you want to understand is, with whatever the person is wearing, where are the ropes? Once you know where the ropes are, every person who has anything close to them that's fabric of any kind can be made into a rope that you can choke them with. So, welcome to the first Rope Mastery Seminar. Shall we? Let's do this. All right, so check this out. From the guard, okay, you pull it up, still on the back rope. You get as high as you can, you're here. Look, instead of coming under, stay in the high hold, your hand goes in and go over. Got him. This is the moment in the seminar where you say, Henner, you were right.
Stop it.
This is the moment, because a gi can't do what you just saw. That doesn't exist in the gi. That was a back rope Ezekiel choke from the guard. And that's why I would rather you wear a t-shirt in a fight. If I'm fighting you, I'd rather you be wearing a t-shirt than a gi because of what you just saw. Stage one, high bundle. Look, once you're here, look at that. This guy goes in the hole backwards, comes across and grabs here, pops some threads. Love it. And then extend both arms. So it's one, it's, look at this, not here. It's pull, full bundle, like Hito mentioned. From the hug, I'm still hugging his neck, but instead of going under, I just go right where my fist is. That's the unity. And then I pierce it, and then I take that hand, and I go grab this forearm. I'm gonna loosen up my back grip just to soften it up a little. And then from those grips, look at that. It's a triangle on his neck. It's one, two, three. And the most important part of the triangle is that the apex is in front of his throat. So there's a V, like any rear naked choke or any triangle, we're getting bilateral carotid artery compression, one side with the fabric, one side with the wrist, and all strengthened by the fact that I'm holding it. And now I straighten both arms, and it's over. Okay, it's one of the best, you guys. This is the one. This is what you came for. This and variations like it, and on a t-shirt, when you never imagined that this type of strength and effectiveness could be created there.
You guys, that was just a free sample. The complete Street Choke Mastery Seminar that will change your life forever is now available online. Over 1 hour and 45 minutes of instruction on 16 different variations of chokes that will convince you that if you had a choice, you want your street fight opponent to be wearing a t-shirt, not a gi, not a no gi, a t-shirt. This seminar will change your life forever or your money back.